Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad that we are holding these hearings, though I regret this marks another year in which our House had only a matter of hours to review the resolution before voting on it. This occasion also failed to include budget bills with that resolution. I believe we must do better and believe that this theme of transparency and fairness extends into this year's Senate Democrat Conference budget priorities, some of which I raise here for everyone's consideration. Support for local highways, federal budget changes, and years of flat support for the CHIPS program have left local roads and bridges in a declining state of repair. Locals need a similar increase to last year's support and need a dedicated funding stream that adjusts for inflation. Supporting upstate transit. Transit operators upstate are often the sole means of transportation for so many of our elderly, disabled, and low-income New Yorkers upstate. The enacted budget needs to provide more stable revenue stream for transit that adjusts with inflation. Haven't we had a bad enough experience with transportation trust fund subsidies, bike and pedestrian infrastructure? The federal budget changes and years of burst revenues prevent implementation of complete street law. We should dedicate a piece of highway capital aid for bike and pedestrian projects across the state. Bus rapid transit on the Tappan Zee Bridge. This budget also ignores the recent proposal for bus rapid transit along the Tappan Zee Bridge and corridor 287 corridor. The New York State Thruway should be required to prepare a financing plan for the Tappan Zee with bus rapid transit rolling stock and infrastructure included. The MM Tower sweep. The executive budget doubles last year's proposal to sweep operating funds, $40 million away from the MTA. I hope the legislature keeps its word to eliminate the sweep and protect services. Progress in freight and passenger rail. Freight and passenger rail are both vital, efficient parts of our infrastructure that rarely receive much attention. Our last rail plan identified over $1.6 billion in needs over 5 years, with only $20 million expected to be split between the two. This prevents development throughout the state. Infrastructure issues become more apparent every day as we confront one derailment after another of new oil shipments. Speed cameras. It is unclear why speed cameras are being expanded this year in New York City when New York City's pilot program is still ongoing. If we already know that they are proven technology, we should be using them to protect children upstate as well. Further, the language needs to be included in the law, not just in the resolutions. Planning. I applaud the Senate resolution's inclusion of funding for the Sheridan Expressway study. However, I did not find any corresponding appropriation in the capital projects budget. This and funding for bicycle and pedestrian feasibility study for the Tampa Sea Corridor should be lined out. I look forward to discussing these ideas over the course of this budget and legislative session and welcome an open debate on these issues. Thank you.